Today, I'm going to show you how to set up MongoDB. And before we will start, remember to subscribe our channel with the red button down there and to give us some likes and to leave a comment. Let's start. Everyone. As I mentioned before, today we are going to learn how to set up MongoDB. Some of us would like to use this kind of database in our projects. It's kind of easy to use, and also we can set up it for free in the internet. I'm going to show you how to do it in Atlas Mongo, so don't worry, it's free, you can use it online, and you don't have to set up the MongoDB on your own environment, so any of us can have a different computer and the setup would be somehow different. That's why we are going to do it online, so everybody will have the same. Let's start. Okay, so we will start from the main page of MongoDB Atlas. I will leave you the link in the description, so you can go straight there. And here we are going to start with Start Free button. So let's press it and let's see what we can do. So right now we are on the registration form and here we have two options. One is to use Google and sign in with Google. If you have any Google account, that's kind of a fast and convenient method. And besides that, we can use the traditional form, and this is what I'm going to do right now. So let's select that we are using MongoDB to learn. The company is optional, so I'll leave it. Let's pass an email. When you will register, you will get the email with for this email address, so it's good to put the real one. Name, surname, and the password. Okay, and let's get started. It takes a second. Great, right now we are on the second screen and we are continuing our account setup. So let's go to the first card, and here we have to pass our name of our organization and the project. Our organization name can be our business name, team, or an individual. I will put here personal projects. Remember to name it in the best way for you to understand what's going on. And the project name for the purpose of this tutorial, let's put here blog dev, taking into consideration that we are setting up the database for the development environment. So that's why I put dev at the end. The next card is about selecting the preferred language. So you can select between JavaScript, C++, C#, Go, and many, many more. And this is kind of important because later you can use some ready snippets, which is kind of convenient, but if you will select wrong right now, there's no point to worry because you can change it. So I'll select JavaScript and let's continue. Okay, right now we are on the choosing path. There are three types. There is shared clusters, dedicated clusters, and dedicated multi-region clusters. The last two options are paid. We are going to use the first one, which is free for the purpose of this tutorial and also for your development. You can feel free to use the free option. So let's click create a cluster. And right now we are taken to create a cluster form. Here we can choose the cloud provider, and there are three of them, the most popular. And we can choose between AWS, Google Cloud, and Azure. For the purpose of this tutorial, we are going to use AWS. Of course, if you would like to experiment or try something else that's better for your project, feel free to select that. That shouldn't be a big difference. After that, we also need to select the location. And in case of location, take into consideration the location of your audience. So if you are planning your application to be done in Europe, then for example, Ireland or Germany can be a great idea. Or also take into consideration where your server will be. Okay, for the purpose of this tutorial, I will select Frankfurt. The next point here is cluster tier. So we can select the space that we need. And here you have three options. One is M0 sandbox, so it's 512 megabytes and it's shared. And it's of course free, and that's what we are going to select. We can have here 500 connections and we have 100 databases. So that's totally fine for our testing project. We can also select between M2, which is 2 GB, and M5, which is 5 GB, but they cost. So if you need more space, more connections, more databases or collections, or a better performance, then think about the different ones. Let's go to another option called additional settings. And in additional settings, we can turn on the backups. We can use backups from M2 and higher. That's for the paid options. And if you are selecting the paid options, it's a really great idea to turn it on, because backup can save your life, not once. So I totally recommend it if you have the option enabled. And the last tab is cluster name, so we can change it to understand more what's going on in our MongoDB Atlas Cloud. So I'll call mine blog, because we are assuming that the project that we need database for is blog. Okay, and now the cluster is being created. It might take a few minutes, so let's wait. And then we are going to create the database access. Okay, it seems that it's done and our cluster is created. So right now let's go to this database access tab on the sidebar menu here. And we are going to create the user for our database. Let's press add new user. And at first we have to select authentication method. We can select between three different: password, certificate, and AWS IAM. For the purpose of this tutorial, we are going to select the password. And with this password authentication, we need to create a username. I will do it block admin, and the password. You can type your own password, but I think that more secure it will be to auto-generate secure password with the button below and copy it, save it, and make sure that it's secure. Next, we can select database user privileges. So we can select if you want our user to be able to read and write to any database, or just read or just write, or something totally else. And if you like to understand it more, there is a link to the roles and privileges here. The next point is that you can restrict access to specific cluster or data lakes. And we are going to use it right now. So the user we are created will be able to access only databases in this cluster. Okay, And the last thing that we can select here is to set the temporary user, so we can select for how long we want this user to be available. And here in the example there is 6 hours, so after 6 hours the user will be deleted. But we don't want that option. Okay, let's save, and there are some changes happening. It might take a second, but our user is here. Okay, the next point that we are going to do will be to set network access. So let's click on the sidebar menu on the right, network access, and let's click add IP address. So what we are going to do, we would like to allow only some IP addresses to access our database. It's because of the security reasons. So if you are developing from localhost, you should pass here your home IP or any other that you are using. Or if you want to allow the server to connect with the database, then you have to put the IP of your server here. Of course, for the purpose of this tutorial, I'm not going to do it, so I allow the access from anywhere, but never do that. If you want to be sure that your application is secure, you can also select at current IP address, so you don't have to look for your current IP address if you want to add it. And let's press confirm. Okay, the changes are deploying. It also might take a second. The next thing that we are going to do will be to load some sample data, so we will know when we are connecting our database that it works. To do that, let's press these three dots just after the collections in our cluster, and let's select load sample data. And the green button loads sample data set. And we have to wait for a second. It's loading, so you can hear it. You can see it above. It might take a few minutes, so no worries if it will take too long for you. And after it's finished, we are able to go to collections and to see this data if it exists. Oh yeah, here you can see we have some sample Airbnb, restaurants, some different kind of data. Also, thanks to this, we are able to learn what kind of data we can put to MongoDB. Assuming that you don't know that. Okay, right now we can connect to our database. Let's click the connect button in our cluster, and we should see the pop-up with three options. Of course, we can also see the documentation. So our options are connected with the Mongo shell, connect to your application, and connecting using MongoDB Compass. Let's see one by one what they offer. So to use Mongo shell, we need to install some stuff. If we don't have it yet, we would need to install Mongo shell. So let's not do it. The other one is just copy paste the string. So this one looks good, and let's check the last one. Here we would need to install MongoDB Compass. We are not going to do it right now. So I think that the best option could be this connect. Let's connect to application. Also take a look here that we can select the different driver and different versions. So that's can be really, really cool because we can get the ready code here, and also we can press this checkbox include full drive code example, and everything will be ready for us to copy paste it in our application. Just remember that this password space you need to change for your real password. Thanks for watching the full tutorial. I hope you will find it useful, and now you can easily set up MongoDB for your next project without any issues with your computer and have it online. I believe you will find it useful. If yes, of course leave us a comment if you would like to see a setup of any different database. Also leave us a comment and we will consider creating the video like that. So
remember about thumbs up and comment and subscribing our channel if you don't do it yet with the red button down there. And also remember to check out our other social media so you are updated with all the promos, news and lots of interesting stuff. I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!